My name is Dr. Eugene Gu, and I am the co-founder and CEO of a telemedicine company called CoolQuit. CoolQuit offers free telemedicine services for patients to be evaluated for coronavirus symptoms, and we also offer smoking cessation services for patients to combat the tobacco epidemic, which claims over 480,000 American lives every year. But today, I want to talk about telemedicine in a broader sense, in that why is telemedicine so important during this very critical time of the coronavirus pandemic, how we can use telemedicine to help patients during this critical time, and why telemedicine is here to stay in the long run, even after this pandemic is over. So first, why is telemedicine important during the coronavirus pandemic? Well, first of all, without telemedicine, all patients would have to go to the hospitals, to the clinics, to the urgent care centers for in-person care and testing when it comes to the coronavirus. And as we've seen in America and all around the world in many other countries, when patients crowd the hospitals, they not only endanger themselves, but they endanger healthcare workers and they endanger other patients by potentially spreading the coronavirus to others. And in addition to that, it consumes a lot of personal protective equipment, from gowns and gloves and masks that healthcare providers are running low on, because every time they see a new patient, they have to, you know, don all their gowns and gloves, put on their mask, and waste a set of really valuable personal protective equipment for each patient that they see in person. And with telemedicine, we can actually eliminate all of those requirements for personal protective equipment because we're seeing patients virtually. There's no need to have a gown or glove or mask, and we can save that for situations where it is required to see a patient in person, where the healthcare provider needs to use that equipment for those situations. So that's why telemedicine is extremely important during the coronavirus pandemic by protecting healthcare workers, protecting patients, and saving the necessary equipment that we need to save the most lives possible. So now on to my second topic about how we can use telemedicine during the coronavirus pandemic to help the most patients possible. Well, the most efficient way to do this is to create a very effective screening questionnaire form, like the ones that JotForm enables healthcare providers to do. Now with JotForm, you can create a set of questions to evaluate patients for coronavirus symptoms so that you can stratify them into high, low, or medium risk. And if you have a high volume of patients coming to you, like the way it is during a pandemic where many people can get sick at once and overwhelm the healthcare system, you can actually prioritize your time and your healthcare resources to the patients who need it the most. So instead of seeing every single patient, whether they just have the sniffle or a patient who has, you know, high fever, severe shortness of breath, then you can actually prioritize your resources to the patients who have the shortness of breath, the fever, the dry cough, the symptoms that make you most worried about the coronavirus. And you can put on the back burner patients who don't have any symptoms at all, but are applying to you because they are scared or anxious about having the coronavirus. In this way, we can help the most patients possible during this pandemic and save the most lives, leveraging the resources of telemedicine to help people. So now on to my last and final point about why I believe that telemedicine is here to stay even after the coronavirus pandemic is over. So we know that telemedicine is extremely useful during the pandemic because it saves PPE, personal protective equipment. It reduces the chance and potential for the spread of the coronavirus by preventing patients from coming to the clinics where they can be in contact with more healthcare providers and other patients who may have the virus. But in addition to all of that during the pandemic, even after this really critical time is over, telemedicine will continue to be an important and influential force in the field of healthcare. And that's because telemedicine greatly increases the ease of access for patients and connects them with doctors and healthcare providers in the comfort of their own home. This is extremely important for patients who live in rural areas and are far away from a clinic, where traveling to the clinic can be burdensome and expensive. And this is also extremely important for patients who have disabilities and mobility issues, where going to the clinic can be an actual really hard ordeal on them. And in addition to the increasing ease of access for patients when it comes to telemedicine, the other benefits is that telemedicine vastly reduces healthcare costs. By using telemedicine, you can have much more efficient follow-up with your patients and keep track of their symptoms, keep track of their chronic conditions, so that you can reduce hospital admissions and just leverage the power of this new technology to maintain closer contact with your patients and to improve the continuity of care that is extremely important in medicine. So I hope you found this video at least somewhat useful and informative. As a healthcare provider, either starting your own telemedicine practice from scratch, joining a telemedicine practice, or to improve an existing one. And I just wanted to thank you for helping patients during this really scary and critical time of the coronavirus pandemic. We're all in this together, and especially as a healthcare provider, you're performing just the most essential service for our patients and for our country. So thank you. All right, till next time.